side action, and we're just about set to kick off. Let's head down to the coin toss now. It's brought to you by Coke Zero. Real Coca-Cola taste and zero calories. Enjoy everything. Both teams are on the field, and we're just about ready to open things up. He just drills this one. This one's going to be down in the end zone for a touchback. Now the offense gets ready to take their first crack at it. Gains his way to the 33-yard line.
That's good for a gain of 8 yards. That makes it 2nd and 2.
Has some daylight. Gets to around the 42. So he keeps it, and he gets a big first down.
The quarterback made a very good decision here not to pinch. He saw a break in the defense and just hit it for a big gain.
He might have a chance. He's tackled
at about the 47-yard line.
He kept it himself and picked up a good-looking first down.
Great execution and a good decision there by the quarterback.
Here's the handoff, and he's taken down for a loss.
You know, as a running back, you've got to get upfield north and south. That time, he just seemed to wait and kind of delay his reaction and just got to be able to make a read, get upfield as quickly as possible. In college football, and especially up in the NFL, the more you're dancing around waiting for a big play, the more time you're giving an athletic defense a chance to come and make a play in the backfield against you, and that's what happened.
Throws it in a hurry. Tackle at the 38-yard line.
With the reception. Number 30 with the tackle. At the 38-yard line. Number
32. And he carries the ball for a nice game.
Call it a gain of 5 yards. First down.
He has some room. That's a great tackle at the 23.
That makes it 1st and 10.
He's out of bounds at the 16-yard line.
Gain of 7 on the play. That'll bring up 2nd and 3.
They hand it off. Tackle outside after a nice pickup.
That's good for a gain of 4 yards. First down.
Might have been some early movement up front.
False start. Offense.
That penalty will move them back a bit.
Yeah, with so many young guys out there, it's bound to happen occasionally.
So the penalty will make it 1st and 15. Strike to his receiver, no good.
These receivers need to be ready because he's capable of really launching some passes. That one was just out of reach.
And this is the 11th play of the current drive. The 5, and down he goes, around the 4-yard line. Touchdown, Florida Atlantic.
That's what makes this offense so tough to defend. When you have a quarterback with the ability to run and throw and he gets down into this area of the field, chances are he's going to find his way into the end zone.
And he adds the extra point. So a 12-play, 81-yard drive, and they get it in for 7. Everyone's all lined up and ready for the kickoff. Fielded at the 4.
And down he goes at the 30-yard line. The quarterback leads the team out on the field for the first drive. Nice run, and he's brought down. He's taken down at about the 35.
That might have actually been a situation where he should have kept it. The back didn't have any room to run.
It's third and five. Ball on the 35. And he's sacked.
Absolutely perfect call by the defensive coordinator. He brought just the right amount of pressure from the right direction, and it seemed to confuse the offense.
There's a missed tackle. And we see this offense again after what you, Kirk, called a very physical touchdown drive.
Well, I say that, Brad, because the big hog mollies up front were able to create holes for the running game, and it helped them get the score. Let's see if they can do it again.
Nice run there as they worked the outside. He kept it himself and picked up about 6 yards. Florida Atlantic is up by a touchdown. He's at the 40. Tackle made at the 32-yard line.
It's great when a running attack comes through for the first down like this. It makes an offense so much more versatile.
Steps out of bounds at the 31. Throw it in a hurry, and he's taken down at the 18-yard line.
That makes it first and 10.
Got it and brought down immediately.
Number 23 makes the tackle at the 13-yard line. That brings him second and 5.
And he throws it away. From the 13-yard line, third down. Complete pass and hit hard as he came down with it. Well, he caught it, but it's almost no yards gained, and now it's fourth down.
Give props to the D here for coming up with a big stop on third down.
Florida Atlantic can make this a two-possession game with his field goal. It's up, and it is good. And it looks like they're ready for the kickoff. From the 8-yard line. He's taken down at the 38. The last time this offense had the ball, it was 3 and out.
They've been beaten soundly on both sides of the ball, and we haven't even gotten to the second quarter.
And they get him in the backfield for a loss. He had nowhere to go on that option play.
Boy, you're right. He's lucky he held onto the football there.
That'll bring up second and 11.
From their own 37-yard line, second down. Big opening. reversal and open field tackle. A lot of concern from his teammates with a guy down on the field. Inside handoff. And they make the stop at the 49. We played one quarter. FAU in front, 10-0. And we're back for more action here in quarter number two. Well, Kirk, good news. We saw him go to the locker room a little bit earlier with that injury, but apparently he's all right. It looks like he's going to get back in the action here. And they get nice yardage on that run. They'll bring him down at the 49-yard line.
The entire defense just collapsed on that run and got penetration into the backfield. Nice job by the safety to clean up the mess.
The defense looks like they're going to send in the cavalry on this one. And it goes into the end zone, down for a touchback. You think about the challenges these two teams are facing. On one side, you've got to find a way to keep building on your lead, and on the other side, you've got to find a way to get back in it. He's scrambling. Got an opening. He's out to the 30. Fumble, loose ball. It's scooped up.
Once the ball hits the ground, it's a matter of luck and will. And on that play, it was the defensive end who corralled it for his side.
It was a pretty one-sided first quarter, but I wouldn't be surprised if things changed in a big way before halftime. There are five wide receivers split out, the quarterback in the gun. He makes it out to maybe the 36-yard line. Catches it, and he's looking for more. And he hits him hard at the 23-yard line. They'll spread the field with five wide. Brought down at about the 23-yard line. Steps up at the 19. Now he tries to buy some time. And he's going to come up with a sack.
Call a loss of 1 yard on the play. Fourth down.
It's fourth down. They'll line it up for the field goal. And they can make this a one-possession game with this kick right here. He gets it up, and the field goal is good. They line up to kick this one away. He'll return it from the three. They'll bring him down at the 26-yard line. They coughed up the pigskin the last time they had the ball. Let's see if they can hold on to it this time.
I look for the offense to come out with the same game plan as before. You don't make changes after one play.
Fires out quickly to the tailback. And he's tackled at the 34-yard line.
Number 43 brings him down at the 34-yard line.
Florida Atlantic is up a score. And he's level at the 45-yard line.
That makes it first and 10.
Just throws this one away.
Great job by the defense of getting after that quarterback. And right now, I think they've got him with some happy feet. He appears to be a bit rattled.
From their own 45-yard line, second down. Screen pass. He's got his halfback. He's at the 40. He's at the 30 to the 20. And they push him out at the 16.
The quarterback dumped it off, and everyone did a good job of blocking up front. Doesn't get much better than that.
Intercepted.
Brady drops the ball here. I don't know if he's starting to peek downfield and think about the return or what, but that ball's right in his hands. He just dropped it.
From the 16-yard line, it's second down. Quick strike to the receiver. Touchdown, Owls.
Well, it's all about the receiver on this play. He beat his man off the line and then ran a perfect route. All he had to do after that was make the catch.
And he converts the extra point.
That's what I'm talking about, baby.
The kicker looks like he's ready to kick this one off. And he got all of this one. Great kick. And it goes into the end zone, down for a touchback. They're set to go for another round. He's tackled around the 38-yard line. Midfield makes it to the 44. They go with the option and pick up the first down.
Yeah, and that was a situation where the quarterback knew he could pick up the first down if he kept it himself. That's a good decision.
Gets out to around the 32. Is about 3 feet away from that first down marker. Here's the pass, broken up. Well, he tried to thread the needle with that pass.
Well, here the quarterback makes a poor decision throwing into coverage. Needs to look at his progression and find the second and third receiver.
Tackled for a loss, and they'll turn it over on downs. And so now the ball's turned over on downs.
And the defense looked like they were expecting option on that play. Great job to pin them up and cause the turnover on downs. And the last time we saw this offense on the field, they drove the length of the field. And you think back to what that defensive coordinator tried to do. He tried to change some things up, but nothing seemed to work. It's going to be interesting to see how he can have an impact on this drive.
Fires out to his receiver. Tackle right around the 44-yard line.
First down.
just gets rid of it.
Brad, I just think this quarterback's got to do a much better job of being able to read that defense and make quicker decisions. And especially when the defense starts to get pressure, you've got to either get rid of that football or check it down or take off and run. This quarterback is tough as nails. Brad, he's going to sit in that pocket and give himself a chance. The only problem is, at some point, you've got to have a feel, almost that sixth sense on when to get out of there and avoid the pressure or just to throw the ball before you get hit.
He's going to air it long. And he's immediately tackled.
What a huge letdown by the defense on a big third down play. Man, that is just inexcusable.
Now it's first and 10 after the big pass play. Makes it to the 12-yard line. A couple, maybe 3 yards on that run.
You're not going to be able to get by a sure tackler like this linebacker too often.
They go with the screen here, and the halfback's got it. Touchdown, Florida Atlantic.
Tremendous example of the type of chemistry that these two players enjoy. When a quarterback and a receiver are on the same page, good things tend to happen.
He makes the PAT. The Owls had one of their key guys go down earlier, but it looks like he might be able to return. Sends it sailing downfield. This one's going to be down in the end zone for a touchback.
Things are on the verge of getting out of hand before we even hit the half. These next few drives are going to go a long way in determining what kind of game this will end up being.
Zips it to the back. He's pushed out of bounds at the 25-yard line. It's second and 10. Ball on the 25. Quick throw out to the receiver. And down he goes at the 31-yard line. Quickly to the tight end, incomplete.
Number 87, the intended receiver on the play. That makes it fourth and four.
He makes it to the 38-yard line. The Owls are just cruising through this first half, Herbie. Really a comfortable lead here.
Yep, but still a lot of football left to be played. They got to remember that it's a four-quarter game, and even though that first half went pretty well, things can change in a hurry. Brad, let's see if this offense can maintain the rhythm that they established on that last drive. Not just putting points on the board, but driving the length of the field to be able to eventually put points up. I think that's going to be important for them to try to keep that confidence going here on this drive.
Second down, 10 to go. Ball on the 38-yard line. He airs it out. And they intercept it. The junior safety.
What kind of call is that? With a big lead, you're throwing the football, and the interception here could end up costing you.
First and 10. Ball on the 22-yard line. Throws it to the halfback on the screen. And he's shoved out of bounds at the 24-yard line.
That's good for a gain of 2 yards. That makes it second and 8.
He's taken down around the 35-yard line.
Did you see how much space there was for that tailback up front? He better be thanking his offensive lineman for that.
First down, 10 yards to go. Ball on the 35-yard line. Gets out to around the 45.
That's another first down, Brad. And right now, you can just really feel and sense the rhythm that this offense is in. Their ability to pick up first downs, just pushing this defense further and further down, back deep into their own territory.
Swings it out left to the halfback. Tackle made around the 46-yard line.
The quarterback and his receiver make a great play here and convert on an early down.
It's second down now. They're just a few feet away from that first down marker. So we'll probably get one last heave to the end zone here before halftime. So at the end of the half, the Owls lead 24-3.
We've played 30 minutes. Glad to have you with us on the EA Sports NCAA Football 14 Halftime Show presented by Nissan. Innovation that excites. David Pollack and I here in the studio to break down everything that just happened in your game. They make teams underdogs for a reason. We saw the reason in the first half. Very decisive lead right now, and there appears to be very little hope of this team clawing its way out of this hole.
No, I don't know where you're going to take the positives from. It was a really bad first half, and you're the underdog. You'd like to see more, and you'd like to see something that you did well and go, we need to do more of that in the second half. I didn't see anything they did well, Reese. I don't see any way to go, if we do that, we're going to win this ball game. It's not much hope.
We've done what we can do here at halftime. Time to get you back out to the second half. We'll keep an eye on everything going on in college football. Brad Nessler and Kirk Herbstreit ready with a call.
Welcome back, everybody. Second half action about to begin. From the 7. Brought down at the 36. The Owls continue to get it done on the defensive side of the football, Kirk.
Yeah, they've done a good job of building this lead and almost determined here to protect it. Let's see if they can hold on here for the rest of the way.
There's got to be some sense of urgency to this offense right now. They don't have the luxury of wasting drives if they want to get back in the game. And he's taken down at the 36-yard line. He gets sacked on the play. So the sack makes this third and very long.
Four down. Watch the team. Make the team.
Read out. Hey.
He's wrapped up for the sack.
That makes it fourth and long.
The sack makes this a fourth and very long. They're stacking the line. It looks like they're coming after this punt. Oh, excellent punt. He makes it to the 48-yard line.
Return for a gain of 16 yards.
The quarterback leads the offense back out onto the field as we get set to resume play. They make the stop at about the 49.
That's a deep three on the play. That'll make it second and seven.
Check.
That's a great tackle at the 46.
That's good for a gain of 3 yards. That makes it third and three.
Pulls it in, and he's in the open field. That's a tight end who's wide open out there. He has 3 scoring tosses in the game now.
What I'm noticing more and more about this guy is he's very patient with the ball, and it's resulting in some nice scores, just like we've seen today.
tacks on the extra point. Florida Atlantic ready to kick this one off. From the 5-yard line. At the 30. He's taken down at the 36. Tulsa's having a hard time doing anything on offense right now.
Well, they've had some opportunities, but they either turn the ball over or obviously don't execute on third down and they're forced to punt. Or their drive ends up stalling on a fourth down. But they're moving the ball at times. I think they've just got to take some chances at this point late in the game like this. Throw the ball downfield and hope that your receivers can make some plays.
They'll bring him down around the 44-yard line. Down at the 47. And he's tackled at the 37-yard line. Here's an opening. He's tackled around the 26-yard line.
Number 37 brings him down to the 26-yard line. First down.
There's a strike complete. He's down. He scrambles. There's a very impressive open field tackle. It's first and 10. Ball on the 15-yard line. It to the 6-yard line. Play fake. He goes up and gets it. It's a touchdown. How about the tight end? This guy can play some football.
You bet he can. He's such an all-around player. He's just as good at blocking as he is at catching the football.
And he hits the PAT. A 9-play, 64-yard drive, and they put up 7 points.
An amazing drive for this offense, outstanding execution. If you're the defense, you've got to do something to try to change things up to get this quarterback out of sync.
So the score now, 31-10. And it goes into the end zone, down for a touchback. This offense did really well with the air attack on their last trip out there. Let's see if they can do the same thing here.
You can bet this defense made some adjustments on the sideline, though. I don't know if they can stop the passing attack, but they need to at least be able to slow it down.
He makes it out maybe to the 26-yard line. He makes it out to maybe the 29-yard line. He's to the 40. He makes it to the 42-yard line. For Florida Atlantic, they're having success rushing the passer tonight. This defense has been bringing the blitz and is having success getting to him. Well, when this offense does complete a pass, they're not doing that badly.
Yeah, the secondary and linebackers aren't able to make a play at the point of catch a lot of times.
These underdogs are fighting about as hard as you'll see a team fight. They're ready to start another drive, hoping to duplicate the results of the last one, which ended in a touchdown.
So much of the passing game is about the timing between the quarterback and his wide receivers. Right now with this offense, they are in sync, and really the timing and execution is flawless.
Tries to scramble, but he's sacked.
That's a loss of 7 yards. Third down.
So at the end of three, the Owls lead 31-10. Into the fourth quarter now, and we're back to the action.
15 is the mic. I got 15.
Oh, there he's in trouble. He flings it. And he tackles him hard at the 46-yard line. With room to work. He gets hit out of bounds at the 28-yard line.
Not the greatest pass, but a really, really good play by the receiver to bail out his quarterback.
Tackle at about the 15-yard line. Gets to about the 14-yard line.
That brings up second and nine.
Got a man in and out of his hands. They'll line it up again on third down. Gets to about the 11-yard line. The back gets three on the carry.
That'll make it fourth and six.
Setting up blockers, the running back's got it on the screen, and they push him out at the three.
For a back's confidence to get tackled for a loss. But this guy knows that he's got to just keep at it, and the holes will start to open up.
Here's the 11th play of the drive. He's into the open field. Tackled after a decent pickup. He splits the uprights with the extra point.
Yeah.
taken down at the 41. Both teams are well aware that a score on this drive is going to create an almost insurmountable lead. This defense has really got to step it up and make a stop. He makes his way to about the 28. We've got a first and 10. Ball on the 28. Just under three to go in regulation. Tackle after a decent run up the gut.
That's good for a gain of 5 yards. That brings him second and 5.
Down he goes, right around the 14-yard line.
The offensive lineman played that one perfectly, giving the tailback plenty of space to work with, and he took advantage of it.
Makes it to the 5. They go with a run, and that'll be a gain of 9. Short yardage situation here. It's second down and 1. Touchdown, Florida Atlantic. Touchdown should just about ice this one. He makes the PAT. Looks like they're ready for the kick. Nice kick, plenty of distance. This one's going to be down in the end zone for a touchback. Well, they got the result you always want on the last drive. Let's see if it happens again. Aaron and out long. On the reception, look out. Nobody there. Touchdown, Golden Hurricane. Converts the extra point. Tackle at the 45-yard line.
Brad, this is my kind of game. I love seeing this kind of production and the way these quarterbacks are playing. Both teams are challenging both of these defenses.
So now both teams come trotting back out onto the field. Just under 2 minutes in the game. And they got to him before he could get back to the line. 1 yard loss for the halfback.
I'm sure this running back will be looking around for that guy the next time he takes a handoff.
From the 46-yard line, second down. And he is drilled at the 45. Run there. 6 yards there on the option keeper. And it's the offense that takes the field on fourth down. He's got to throw it in a hurry. He lost the ball. The offense scoops it.
Get off here. Get off. Get off. We got it.
I'm sure there are a lot of fans out there hoping for a miracle, but I seriously doubt we're going to see one today.
And they'll try one last pass here to pad the stats, but that's about all they're going to get right here. Steps up in the pocket and sacked. That's the end of the ball game, and our final score in this one, 38-24, Owls.
38 and Golden Hurricane.
That's going to do it for this presentation of NCAA Football 14. For Kirk Herbstreit, this is Brad Nessler saying goodbye.